blessings, yet closing them off from others, possessing your love, yet reluctant to share it, encountering injustice, yet remaining silent or complicit. Lord, we are lost. Let your forgiveness find us again and again, and free us for service.
Holy God, as we join Jesus on his journey to the cross, let us discover you once again, for you are our relentless God who refuses to give up on us. Pursue us, find us, forgive, and embrace us. We praise you and give you thanks that nothing in all of creation can ever separate us from your love in Christ Jesus.
Amen.
Talk talking about one of the most famous verses in all of the Bible. It's called John 3:16. Has anyone ever been watching a basketball game or a football game and seen someone with a sign that says John 3:16? You have? Possibly. Your hand was just up because you were excited about something else, yes? Well, you're fired up and I like it. I like it a lot. Now, the verse says that God so loved the world that he gave his one and only son who was named
Jesus.
Okay, you guys are doing a great job. That's really good. So that they might live. Now, I got a big question for you today. When you think about the world, see how it twirls? Is the world big or small? What would you say? You can yell it out. Big. Gigantic. Big. Large. Grandiose. Okay. We're going to talk a little bit about this word world, and it's actually bigger than world. It was written with this word called planta. Can you all say the word planta with me? Planta. And it means everything. Now put your thinking cap on. What is bigger than the world? Yes, what's bigger than the world? The universe! Sometimes I like to say universe like that, you know what I mean? The universe! Because it's just so big. You got something. A galaxy is bigger than the world. Yes, there's more. What? The Milky Way. We're talking Andromeda. What do you got? The sun is bigger than the world. Yes. What about you? Jupiter is. You guys are super smart and you know stuff. Okay? The audience participation part's over now. Okay, we're done. Now, we're talking about pretty big stuff. And what is this? What is this cord? What do you think this does? If I were to take this and I were to plug it in, what do you think would happen here? You think it would spin? That would be the best globe ever. I want one. Yes. What do you think? It would light up like a Christmas tree because Jesus himself is the light of the world. And it says in the Bible lesson today that his judgment towards us is light. All good things. So, you've got a few options today. Intern Pastor Matthew is going to be working with the first and second graders on Milestone. It's Not Fair. You might be going back to your seats to sit with your parents or to Sunday school. Now, if you are brand new to Mount Calvary, you can join Sunday school anytime you want. You can jump in at any point. Just see staff in the back. You have been a big thumbs up Bible story. Give yourselves a hand. Just like that. You may go back to your seats.
Thank you.
God did not send the Son into the world to condemn the world, but in order that the world might be saved through him. Those who believe in him are not condemned, but those who do not believe are condemned already because they have not believed in the name of the only Son of God. And this is the judgment, that the light has come into the world, and people loved darkness rather than light because their deeds were evil. For all who do evil hate the light and do not come to the light, so that their deeds may not be exposed. But those who do what is true come to the light, so that it may be clearly seen that their deeds have been done in God. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
You may be seated. Friends, grace and peace to you from our Lord and Savior Jesus, the light-bringing Christ. In this morning's gospel lesson today, we are treated to what is known as the most famous, the most popular, the most quoted verse in all of Scripture, John 3:16. You see it in signs and huge sports concerts, contests, bumper stickers, plane advertisements, and even tattoos. It is a doozy in its ability to both encapsulate why Jesus came and bring the good news to the whole world. And in John 3:16's singularity, without its surrounding grounding, it can be very binary and in turn turn the very best news into a fear-filled drama. And so it is best to look at many verses and chapters of John as we look at this text. Today I'm going to outline chapters 1, 2, 3, and 4. I really am. You're going to go. But you know I don't go super long. You'll be okay. In chapter 1, the Christmas chapter, we're reintroduced to the Word and the Light, both named Jesus, the one who has always been since the very beginning of time itself. John describes grace upon grace, which is overflowing in his gospel. In chapter 1, the word grace appears 7 times. After verse 18 in chapter 1, the word is never mentioned again. Dr. Caroline Lewis from Luther Seminary was here in October, and she kicked off our Chosen series this year. She said that even though the word never appears again, every single thing that Jesus does or says in the book of John is an outpouring and a sign of that grace upon grace. And that good news and that grace upon grace is happening long after the 21 chapters of John reach its conclusion. In fact, that grace upon grace is still overflowing today. Sometimes up here I ask you to do me a favor. I'm going to do it again. During Advent, I ask you to go home and read the entire Christmas story in one sitting to see what you have maybe missed. I'm going to ask you again today, read chapter 1, 2, 3, and 4 of John in one sitting in its entirety. Now, if you're feeling a little rowdy and you want to clear your schedule, go ahead and read all 21 chapters in one sitting. But read it like a novel. Read it like a biography and see what you notice. Chapter 1 is called Prologue, and we use it at Christmas time, for it sets the stage with the calling of the disciples and the introduction of John the Baptist, Jesus' cousin, who is not the same John who wrote this gospel. In fact, the name John back in Jesus' time was even more popular than it is now. And in chapter 2, we witness Jesus' very first miracle, or sign, as John refers to them. Jesus' very first sign is turning water into wine at a wedding so that the wedding can continue. But it is far more than that. Jesus' first sign he does because, well, his mother tells him to. And the wine is a symbol for that grace upon grace flowing freely and steadily and overabundantly. There is more than enough for everyone. Oh, but this isn't just wine. It is the very best wine you have ever tasted. Further in chapter 2, Jesus cleanses the temple, which Pastor Brenda preached for us The Chosen makes Nicodemus a central character and helps us see just who Jesus came for. Our verse 14, where we started today, comes right in the middle of an answer that Jesus is giving Nicodemus. As you read chapters 3 and 4 of John, notice the similarities and differences between the two chapters. In chapter 3, Jesus is talking to Nicodemus. And in chapter 4, Jesus is speaking with the woman at the well. Nicodemus comes at night. The Samaritan woman is in broad daylight. Nicodemus is a man. The Samaritan woman as well, a woman. I wish she was named like Nicodemus is named, but alas, she is not. Now, church, if all goes well today, like we think it's going to go at our congregational meeting, one of our staff will be planning his ordination in the next coming weeks. 13 years ago, right now, I was putting together my ordination. Now, at your ordination, you get to choose the whole service, including the main gospel reading. For mine, I chose John chapter 4 in its entirety, the woman at the well, because I believe it encapsulates Jesus' mission and ministry so well. He finds this woman like he finds the whole world, and in chapter 3, Jesus finds Nicodemus as Nicodemus is finding Jesus. And Jesus tells him, for God so loved the world. Like I just told the kids, the word used here is panta, and it is all-encompassing. It is better translated the entire cosmos, everything we can see and everything we cannot see. Now, Nicodemus, being a Pharisee, would have known the God who set the Jewish people as chosen like Abraham. Jesus is about to expand and explode that idea of all being chosen. For he next goes to the most unlikely of places to prove his point. He goes to Samaria, a place of the other. Jesus is about to flip the tables over once again. You see, John 3:16 needs John 3:17 right after it. Indeed, God did not send the Son into the world to condemn the world, but in order that the whole world might be saved through him. This past year, I've seen a meme on Facebook that goes something like this. Maybe you've seen it too. If God did not send Jesus to condemn the world, I'm pretty sure God did not send you to condemn it either. So, stop condemning. Start bringing light. These verses talk about those who believe, those who are perishing, talks about judgment, evil, hate, darkness, and light. A few weeks ago at Tech Study, Pastor Brenda named this sermon title for me and for us, The Judgment is Light. After you look at all of those, what I would call scary words, who's in, who's out, who's believing, who's not believing, who's perishing, who has eternal life, John brings chapter 1 right back to us. The judgment is not perishing. The judgment is not condemnation. The judgment is not hell or evil. The judgment is light. And who or what is the light? The light. The judgment is light is Jesus. Jesus comes in judgment full of grace and truth. Grace upon grace, overflowing upon overflowing grace. Just like the best wine. Just like grace and mercy when you do not deserve it, and it is delicious. And it is for the whole world, no exceptions. No yes buts, no but what about those people? Just how big is your us? If it is not getting bigger and bigger, like the ever-expanding cosmos, you're not thinking big enough. Because God builds banquet tables to fit everybody. You, church, are a city on a hill, and a city provides great light to the whole world, and that light of Christ is brighter grace upon grace for a hurting and starving and warring world. Now, I understand fully that there seems to be a condition in verse 16 for those who believe, but read further. That condition is met in the person of Jesus. Because every single person has failed, every single person has disbelieved, fallen short, and so Jesus has come, and Jesus is the light. There is judgment, oh yes, but it is the most beautiful, life-giving, grace upon grace-filled light of judgment that you can ever imagine. It is a showering kaleidoscope of grace. It is filled with light to overflowing. The judgment, church, is light. Now go and bring that light to every corner of the cosmos. Amen.
He suffered death
and was buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and Son, who with the Father and Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come.
Congregation, along with all of God's children, let us pray for the church, those in need, and all of God's creation. Let us pray. Almighty God, we thank you for your amazing love. We praise you for your mercy and grace. But no matter who we are or what we have done, you love us so tremendously that through your Son Jesus, you have saved us and promised us salvation, eternal life with you. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We come before you with so much on our minds, the turmoil in the world, the divisions in our country, friends and loved ones hurting and in need. We know that you care for and love everyone. Be in all these situations, bringing peace, reconciliation, healing, comfort. Help the world to see your light in your love. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
You have told us we are your handiwork, created in Christ to do good works, that you have even prepared in advance the work for us to do. Help us to see what you would have us do in this world, caring for your creation, the world we live in. Reaching out to those in need with an uplifting word or a hand of help. Listening and spending time with those feeling alone. Help us to be your hands and feet in the world, fulfilling what you have planned for us. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We thank you for the blessing that Pastor Mark has been to our congregation through his words, witness, music, and love. Please be with him as he is officially called as a pastor of Mount Calvary. Help Pastor Mark to always walk closely with you and to work with and minister to our congregation filled with your Holy Spirit. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
To your grace-filled and loving hands of God, we give to you all for whom we pray. We trust in your mercy and your blessings through our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. The peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
Please share the peace with someone near you. Sign up with Zach in the office. And now our ushers will receive our tithes and offerings.
Thank you.
the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me. Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, this cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me. Let us pray the Lord's Prayer together.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Everyone is welcome. You may be seated, and the ushers will direct you forward.
Thank you.
dear Jesus Christ, strengthen you and keep you in his grace forever and always. Amen. Please rise. Whatever wilderness the Spirit has brought you to, walk in boldness as a beloved child of God. Walk in peace under the shelter of the Most High. Walk in faith, knowing Christ walks with you. Amen.